Keisha, Becky.
Pull up and dump off. Twist up your waist and jump off. Free up that number. Oh my God, look at that bumper. What the bumper?
Drip like my chain. Shake that ass, it's insane. Very sexy. Keisha, Becky.
What's up, YouTube?
Welcome back to our channel.
It's your girl, Nou.
And your girl, Cam.
And we're back with another video. Guys, so I think we can all relate that this year, 2020, actually, we don't even say has been just an overwhelming, really toxic year.
Hence, a year of troubles. Trials and tribulations.
Literally, it's just been such a rough year for everyone worldwide. It's been a year that's tested all of us personally with relationships, friendships, everything. School, work, like literally test after test. And we're just being thrown these obstacles and we're just being like, deal with it. So the topic that we wanted to talk about today is none other than
toxicity. So guys, there's a lot of factors that play into toxicity. Toxicity is like a really broad topic. It can be toxic in a lot of ways. So we're going to try to touch on a little bit of everything because, like Nou said, going through a worldwide pandemic, I think the thing that we've all realized is toxicity can play into a lot of aspects of our life. So we're going to start off with toxic
relationships and friendships.
Yeah, guys.
Which I'm sure everybody that is watching this has gone through at least one toxic friendship or relationship in their
lifetime.
Growing up in a generation, especially like ours, things are really confusing. People expect a lot from you. People, you know, demand a lot from you, but are not really willing to give you like what they're demanding. And just knowing how to set your boundaries and knowing how to like choose your circle of people. And like one thing that I can say is like as you get older, you realize that like your circle of people just gets like smaller and smaller and it just gets tighter and tighter. And honestly, like you know the saying where they say it's like quality over quantity, like that's 100% like true. And like don't get me wrong, I'm someone who's like very social. Like I love having like so many people, but like also knowing where to categorize your friends is like super important. Like not everyone sits on the same hierarchy. Like some of your friends are like school friends. Some of your friends are like, okay, like you're like more of a personal friend. Some of your friends are like close with you and your family. Like,
some you know, work friends.
Yeah, like there's different kinds of people in your life. And it's okay to put boundaries and to categorize those people. Like you don't have to please everyone into being like, or just think like everyone's going to be your best friend. And like you expect the most from them and they expect the most from you.
And like not everybody has your best interest at heart. And you have to understand that. And that's completely okay as long as you understand that. Like as long as you understand that some relationships you're going to have are strictly business transactions. Like you're going to have certain people in school that you're friends with. But let's just be honest, outside of your class time, you're not going to spend time with each other. Or, you know, you're not going to do more than maybe set up a schedule that works for both of you guys to study or like just do schoolwork with together. And that's fine, you know. And don't get me wrong, like you can have like meaningful conversations with these people and bond with these people, but these people are not exactly people that, you know, like might have a foreseeable future with you. And just like Nou said, there are some people that will be in like a much higher category with you, and those people are really important to, you know, establish in your life. But at the same time, understanding that like although there is a hierarchy, it doesn't mean people can't switch in and out of levels of this hierarchy. And personally, like I was talking to one of my close friends this year and she was telling me, Cam, like don't ever be worried if you have to like demote people in your life.
You're demoted.
And that's a big thing in life. And I remember I was like, wait, what? But like, that's a really big fact. Like you do not need to understand. Sometimes somebody could be like A1 friend, and don't get me wrong, like I'm not saying cut them out, but like you could demote them and you could just, you know, choose to distance yourself and set boundaries.
Yeah, and guys, like it's important to realize like we're growing, like we're in a society that's changing constantly, and like honestly, like if your life is not constantly changing, at least at the time frame of the age that we're in right now, like you're doing something wrong. So it's okay to realize that there's just going to be people that are periodic friends of yours. Like you go through different phases in life. You're not going to be stuck in the same phase. I hope you're not stuck in the same phase, like, you know, for a few years. Like, so there's going to be people that come and go in and out of your life, and it's nothing personal. It just means that you grow. Like You need to be surrounded by people who genuinely make you feel like you're becoming a better person and that you're learning something from them, like, every single day, whether it's something personal, professional, like, educational, like, you can't be surrounded by people because, honestly, like, your circle of friends and the people that surround you, like, they say a lot about you as a person. Like, the people who you give, like, time is money and time is so precious. Like, if you're choosing to give your time to somebody, like, you best believe that you're making, like, you're making something out of that time that you're giving. Like, you know, like, and I'm not saying that, like, every relationship is, like, a transaction or every friendship is a transaction. Like, that's not what I'm saying. But I'm saying, like, out of that, like, that person has to give you something other than make you a better person. Either they, like, make you thrive more, they make you prosper, they motivate you. Like, there's just some people in your life that are just not doing that. And they kind of stagger your growth and they make you, like, they hold you back. They hold you back with them. And, you know, that's not fair to you. Like, you need to move on with your life. If you see that you're stuck in a relationship or in a friendship where you're not moving forward in your life, then, like, it's got to go. Like,
yeah, you should definitely, like, reevaluate that relationship. Oh my god,
that is another thing that, oh my god.
Don't ignore them. All jokes aside, oh, they're pink when, you know, he's 6 foot tall. They're pink when, like, they call you BFF. Like, no.
No.
Like, that doesn't exist. Like, guys, red. Like, my nails, like, red. Like, if it's a red flag, it's a red flag, sis. Like, if you look at, if somebody is not treating you how you should be treated, like, this goes for girls, guys, like, anybody. Like, if you're not being treated how you should be treated, like, no. Like, leave the situation. Like, don't get me wrong. There's nothing wrong with being dramatic and leaving. Like, I don't care if you're at a party, if you're at a meeting, if you're anywhere, you feel disrespected, you feel you're not being treated how you should be treated, you're not comfortable, get up and leave. Yeah. Get up and leave. And trust me, maybe in the moment you'll be like, that was dramatic. Oh my God. Maybe people will start talking about you, whatever. But it doesn't matter, because as long as you are happy and you make yourself happy, that is all that matters. And, like, to put on to what Nou was kind of explaining about people hindering your growth, there's, like, a famous saying that's like, you are only the average of your 5 closest friends. And that is the truth. Like, if you look at your 5 closest, like, people in your life, you are only the average product of that group. So you need to make sure that that group is, like, headed to where you're headed, is going to where you want to go, has visions like you, is not hindering your growth. And, like, it's so important to know, and I'm sure you guys have all seen these quotes before, but it's so important to know the right time to leave that party, to leave that relationship, to leave that friendship, to leave, you know, anything. And there's nothing wrong with giving people chances and, like, you know, like, getting to know people. But as soon as you kind of, like, see that, you know, there's a couple signs that they're not, you know, in it for the best for you, like, that's toxic and you need to leave before that takes over your life.
And you guys need to realize, like, when you start hanging out with people and you become close to people, you start becoming a little bit like them. And it's natural. Like, it's literally biologically, like, natural that you kind of reflect. Like, when people are in relationship, friendships, like, they become a little bit like that other person. And that's fine, you know? But, like, not to the point where you lose who you are as a person and you lose sight of what you want to be in life. Like, that's when you know, like, this person is not good. Like, if I'm completely changing something and I know that morally or personally, like, I would never do this or I would never stand by this, like, you should know that it's just not, like, there. Because honestly, like, having real friends means having people that respect your boundaries and know where you stand, and they wouldn't make you feel like you're an odd one out for not wanting to do things, not wanting to, like, be around certain people, not wanting to do some things. And, like, I'm sure we've all been in relationships or friendship where we felt like someone was, like, kind of, like, dead weight. Like, you know, I don't mean to be mean, but, like, you know, and it's like when you let go, like, you felt like this sense of, like I can breathe now, you know. And that's something that's so important, like, having people that, like, you can be straight with as well, like, literally being like, I'm not comfortable in this situation, and they know, and they don't put you in a situation where you're not comfortable in, or, like, they respect what you want, is something that is so important. And it ties into toxicity. And, like, you don't realize, like, sometimes being in a toxic relationship and friendship means that you're being toxic within, or that person's being toxic within, and you don't realize, and you guys reflect that upon each other. And that's something that's so important, to sit back and be like, okay, listen, like, this is not gonna work for me, like, this is not it for me. And, like, it's okay to be like, it's just like, I'm gonna exit out of this situation. Like Cam said, like, picking up and leaving sometimes is the mature thing to do, even though you think, like, you're quitting, like, you're not quitting. Like, not everything in this world, and I think that we're so wired to think that you have to make everything work, like, everyone has to love you, like, you grow up, you're going to high school, it's, like, popularity, everyone has to love me, I have to be the it girl, I have to be the it guy, like, you know, I have to be good with all, like, people. it's not like that in real life. Like, we're not made to, like, all love and like each other and be friends. Like, it's okay. Like, you're my kind of people. I'm your kind of people. We're not, like, everyone's kind of people. Like, you know what I mean?
And that's, like, different than respect, guys. Like, don't get that wrong. Like, there's, you should respect everybody and have respect for people, because if you want to be treated respectfully. But that, like Nou says, like, you do not have to like somebody per se. You know, just like we all have different music tastes. Like, you can have different tastes, like, in anything in life, and that's just going to make you guys less compatible. And, you know, like she's saying, like, you guys can have bomb relationships, but, you know, doesn't mean that you guys are going to, like, agree on everything, and for that reason you won't be the same type of people, and, you know, for that reason you guys won't have a close relationship. And to tie into what you were saying, I think we should really talk about what
being toxic within.
Yeah, being toxic within.
Yeah, that's another big one, guys. That's, I feel like, especially in 2020, that's brought, like, it's been brought to light, just because I feel like a lot of people have personally, like, grew this year. Like, you know, like, they've been, like, I've been talking to so many people, and they're like, I felt like this year was so life-changing for me personally, because I truly figured out, like, there's a lot of people in my life that, like, just were not supposed to be there, or, like, I just truly figured out what I like in my life, or what I want to be. And that's something that's so important, you know, guys. Like, you know, like, one thing that I could tell people is, honestly, stop expecting you from other people. Like, you cannot expect that from other people. It's not fair to other people, and it's also not fair to you. Like, you need to set your you can have expectations from what you want in a relationship or in a friendship. That's okay. That's part of self-respect. But you cannot go in and think everybody's going to think like you or be like you.
People
and
can't read your mind.
Yeah, and that's where communication comes into play. Like, a lot of times, relationships and friendships fail because people do not communicate. And a lot of times, I know it's because people are scared to communicate, because they're like, oh, like, I can't tell them that, they're going to get offended. If you have someone like that in your life, then I'm sorry. If you can't be open and honest with them, like, it's just not going to work, and they just don't deserve to be in your life, and you just don't need to be in theirs. Yeah. Like, you should be able to have an open and honest communication and be like, hey, listen, I didn't like when you did that, like, you know, or, like, I would rather if you did this. Like, you know, just be honest with each other, because honestly, like, people let, like, small issues go until it snowballs into something that's, like, so much more bigger than that. And it doesn't have to be like that. And that ties into being toxic within yourself. Like, if you can't just grow up and go say, like, oh, I don't like this, or if you can't be in a situation when you're in a relationship or a friendship like that, then it's not good for you. Like, personally, as a person, like, you're gonna just stay and be, like, more toxic towards yourself, you know? Mm-hmm. And, like, also don't, like, when we talk about hindering, like, your growth, like, don't let yourself be hindered by other people. You need to know when it's time to say no, when it's time to say stop, when it's time to be like, I need to focus on this rather than this, that.
Like, that's, we're like, all self-love.
Yeah, like, we're all human beings. We all like to have fun. We all like to go out. We all like to be social. But, like, there's a time and place for all of that. And if you do not focus on your own personal growth and surround yourself with people who are actually genuinely there pushing you to be better, like, pushing you to, like, you know, touch new horizons, try new things, like, giving you their honest opinions, then you're just hurting yourself in the long run, you know? And just knowing where to pickpocket those people and just to actually, like, you know, like, put that plan into motion is something that's really important. And it ties into being toxic with yourself, because, you know, honestly, if you don't respect yourself, you can't expect anyone to respect you. Like, you really can't.
That's a big one. And I feel like also, guys, you know, you have to really take into consideration, like we mentioned before, like, you don't want to, like, you're not gonna love everybody, so, you know, you shouldn't expect everybody to love you. And that kind of goes into, like, but, like, when it comes to your self-love, you should 100% be your number one own biggest fan. And, you know, like, there's a way to go about it that's not cocky, that's confident. There's a big difference between those two things, but it's a slight line between them. So you want to always be confident and, like, goal-oriented, and make sure that, like, everybody surrounding you is focused on maybe, like, similar goals to you, and, like, making sure that you reach your goals. But self-discipline is the biggest form of self-love, and if you don't have that within yourself, honestly, like, it's just gonna be toxic for you and your entire life, honestly, because self-discipline teaches you to, like, seriously, like, okay, like, I have to focus on my goal. Like, let's say something simple, like a goal, like, maybe a weight loss goal. If you have that goal in mind, nobody's gonna be with you 24 hours to make sure you're following things to make that goal happen. Let's say your friends want to go hang out and you guys have hung out all week already, but you need to hit the gym because you have this goal to hit the gym 7 days a week. You need to tell your friends, guys, I need to go hit the gym. If you want to become a pro athlete, you're not going to become a pro athlete by seeing your friends every day. You're going to become a pro athlete by seeing the gym every day, by seeing that baseball field every day, seeing that soccer field every day. If you want to succeed in school, you're not going to become successful in school by seeing your friends every day or seeing, I don't know who every day, your boyfriend every day, your girlfriend every day. You're going to be successful by seeing the books every day. And if your boyfriend, girlfriend, or friends are not supportive of that, then, you know, that says a lot about them. And but you have to be strong enough and have that willpower and self-love to say, no, this is what I'm, you know, focused on and all that stuff. And really, like, you know, let your friends know, hey, guys, like, I can't make it tonight. And that's you setting your boundaries. And that's okay, you know. But like we said, that starts within yourself. You need to know that yourself. And once you do that and you establish that in your own life, it'll just spread along to the rest of your relationships.
Yeah, for sure. Like, the energy that you give out in this world is the energy that you most likely reciprocate. And if you give out that energy that I'm a go-getter, like I'm a grinder, like I'm gonna do that, like that's the energy that you're gonna get back from the universe, you know?
Yeah,
like,
for sure.
You have to get up and go. Like, no one's gonna work. Like, dreams do not work for themselves. Like, you gotta go and make those dreams apparent. And honestly, we live in a society, in a world where honestly everyone's surviving and everyone's trying to make it for themselves. And if you know, we're already fortunate enough to have so much help from our parents, our friends, our family. Like, you need to take that help and you need to transform it into something that's actually worthwhile, because there's so many people around the world that do not have the resources and the things that you do, you know? So you need to make those things worthwhile, and you have to realize that that starts within you, and that starts within respecting yourself and not being toxic within yourself. Because honestly, sitting there and like just saying like, I'm gonna do it tomorrow, I'm gonna do it today, I'm gonna do it tomorrow, like, you know, procrastination, like, it just doesn't work. It doesn't work. Like, no. You know, it's okay to be lazy. We all have those days. But eventually having like yourself tell yourself like, okay, like, you need to get up right now and you need to do that. Like, you know, it's so important. And it honestly ties into the people that you need in your life as well. Like, you know, when you start being like that, like, if the people around you are worthwhile, they will start pushing you to be like, okay, well, like, didn't you say you wanted to do this? Like, let's get it done, you know? Like, what do you need to do that? Like, what do you need to, like, get that task done? Like, you know, go to the gym, like, yada, yada, yada. Like, you really gotta make those things.
It's all intertwined, you know?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. It's just stuff that's, like, so important. Like, you know, honestly, like, you realize that growing up, like, toxicity is something that you kind of develop and, like, you know, sometimes you don't even realize you're being toxic, and it's okay to take a step back and be like, okay, like, I'm being toxic. And one thing, guys, is like, if you are not happy within yourself and if you are toxic within yourself, you will resonate that to other people, and that's not fair to other people. Sometimes, like, sometimes you'll be going through a phase where you're just like mad at the world, you're mad at yourself, you're like, ugh, like, why isn't this working for me? Like, why are my friends like all happy like this? Or why isn't this like coming for me? Like, when is it gonna be my time? Like, all these things. Like, you have to realize that there's a time and a place, and like, honestly, like, the man above has like a plan for you, and that's okay. And like, just doing whatever you can do to fix the things that are in your control, because honestly, guys, there's some things that are out of your control. Like, yeah. There's some things you can't fix everything in life. Like, some things are just fate. Like, some things are just meant to happen to you. So you cannot try to go and just be like, oh, like, I'm Bob the Builder, like, I'm gonna fix it. Like, it doesn't work like that, you know? Like, there's some things that are, it's just life. Like, you know when they say like, it's just life, like death is just like, it's just life. Like, you know, like, someone being born, like, that's just life. Like, you know, someone getting sick, like, it's just life. Like, there's some things that you just can't explain in life. It's not fair. Like, I'm never gonna sit here and say like life is fair. Like, life, like, some people get dealt amazing cards and some people get dealt like really bad cards. And you know, there's moments in our lives where we feel like we're getting dealt the worst cards, but you always have to remember there's someone getting like dealt worse cards than you in that moment. And it's about taking those cards and transforming them into something that's better, and realizing that once you do that and you have a positive outlook on things, like, no matter how bad life is going for you, like, you will attract good energy into your life. Because I'm telling you, like, you honestly attract what you put out there. If you put out there that you don't have no motivation, no self-respect, like, all you want to do is have fun, like, you're not really about your grind, you're gonna attract people who are like that in your life. But once you start attracting, like, no, I'm someone who's about my grind, I'm about school, like, I'm about all these things, you're going to start attracting people into your life who kind of resonate the same energy as you. And those people are only going to help you grow, you know? And that's something that's so important to realize, that, like, it starts within you. Like, it's all about you at the end of the day. Like, I always tell Cam, like, you are your own, like, biggest enemy. Like, you, if you say to yourself, like, I'm a loser, like, I'm dumb, like, all this stuff, like, no one is saying that but you. At the end of the day, you, because honestly, someone can sit here and insult you all they want, but unless you choose to process that and accept that, like, it's just not valid. You know, like, you, like, allow yourself to feel those emotions. And if you let people get to you like that, and if you let people bully you like that and just kind of, like, make you feel like that, that means you do not have enough self-love and, like, respect, and you're just being toxic within yourself, you know? And, you know, life is not fair, like I said again. Like, I don't want to be repetitive, but life's not fair. Like, it's not easy. Like, I'm not even to sugarcoat it. Like, growing up, as you go, like, you have more and more obstacles, but you also have more tools within you, and you have more knowledge, you know? You hope to have more strengths, and having that solid base of people in your life around you is really important, you know? Because honestly, there's going to be one day where you're in a relationship or a friendship and you're pulling 80% and I'm pulling 20 because I can't pull 80% today, you know, or I can't pull my 50%. And there's going to be days where, like, you're, like, pulling the 20 and I'm pulling the 80, and that's normal, you know?
Yeah.
But being in a constant, like, friendship or relationship where you're constantly, like, pulling 90 and they're only pulling 10, and, you know, you're just dragging yourself down to the point where your energy is just, like, runs out, is something that you can't do, you know? Because honestly, like, at the end of the day, no one's got your back but you. Like, you're fortunate enough to do have help, but, like, honest to God, no one's gonna go to school for you, no one's gonna get a career for you, no one's gonna, you know, live in a life for you. Like, you have to go do that for yourself, especially in, like, living in a city like Toronto where things are, like, really expensive, like, things is really hard. Like, you have to go and be, like,
a go-getter.
Like, you have to be a go-getter. Like, there's, yeah, no,
whatever you're going to get, you know?
Yeah,
so
for sure.
Whatever your goal is, you know, like, you really have to set it for yourself and make sure you achieve it. And, you know, make sure that you play your cards in a way that you achieve it, you know? Always, like, a big thing, I think, is knowledge. Like, you know, make sure you don't lack knowledge, guys. Although we live in the time of, like, the internet, like, I have a phone at my hand at any second, it doesn't mean that we're living in the smartest time ever, you know, the era. You should always, you know, get, like, mentors, get people in your life that, you know, are doing what you want to do, you know, get, you know, advice from them and all that stuff. And, you know, make sure that you're really, like, playing everything out for the best possible outcome for you. Like Nou mentioned before, like, we don't want to say that the field is even in life. It's not, you know. Some of us are dealt, like, amazing cards, some of us are dealt horrible cards, and the field is rocky. It's not fair. We all have to take different, you know, paths to get there. But it's really about you realizing, okay, what are the tools I have in my toolbox, and how am I going to be able to get to my end goal in, you know, the best outcome, you know, maybe the shortest time, maybe you're, you know, you're in a rush, or, you know, I want to take my time but I want the best outcome, this and that, you know. So make sure that, you know, you always have, like, these things figured out for yourself.
Yeah, and guys, honestly, like, be realistic. Like, don't be too hard on yourself. Like, Rome was not built in a day. You are not going to become the dream person you want tomorrow. Like, you're not going to have $1 million in your account tomorrow. It takes time. Like, there's process for this. Like, you know, like, people are fortunate enough to win the lottery, and that's luck. But at the same time, like, life is not that simple. Like, life requires a lot of strategy. It requires a lot of calculation. It requires a little bit of spontaneous, like, things. Like, it requires fun, it requires love, like, it requires a lot of things. Like, you know, like, there's a lot of parts in life. Like, it's not just work. Like, you also need to sit down and do what makes you happy. Like, you need to stop pleasing those people behind the screen, because honestly, those people behind the screen will always have something to say about
you.
No matter how well you're doing, no matter how good you're looking, no matter whatever, someone's always gonna look at you and honestly just be like, oh, like, you know, like, this person do better. Like, oh, I think she's not that pretty. Like, no, it's just like that. You know, we're built to be so judgy because everyone, like, is just, you know, I feel like nowadays, like, no one wants to support nobody, and, like, it's just how society's built, which is really sad, because honestly, people should be uplifting other people, and it's not even in times of need where you should be like, oh, I'm uplifting you. Like, even when someone's doing good, like, you know, keep uplifting them, you know. But, like, honestly, just be realistic and stop trying to satisfy people. You need to satisfy yourself. Like, that's the number one person, because, like, just like you are your own biggest enemy, you're also your biggest fan. You should be your biggest fan. Like, you should look at yourself in the mirror, like, every day and be like, you know, like, I'm that person. And, like, honestly, like,
I'm the main character.
Like, I love myself more than anyone probably loves me. And that's important. Like, self-love is something that's, like, so lacked in our generation, I feel like. You know, people just look to the internet, look to, like, social media for so much validation. They compare themselves, like, oh my god, I'm not as skinny as this girl, I'm not as good looking, I'm not as smart as this guy, I'm not as athletic, like, I'm not, like, doing well, like, this person has, like, such a good job, but, like, how,
so toxic.
Like, how does this person have, like, so much money? Like, guys, let me tell you, like, social media is on all that stuff is so trumping. It is so trumping. Like, what you see online is literally a mere representation of what someone's life could be. Like, I'm being so serious. Like, stop looking at that and thinking that that is real life, because it's not. Like,
if you have
know?
To delete your apps, do it.
Yeah,
like you getting off the internet is not crazy. It's not the most like amazing thing ever. Like, you know, like, yeah, like it could be a really great experience for you, but like it's not gonna be like something that kills you to get off the internet, even if it's just for a couple of days or a couple of weeks. Like, you know, like just delete your apps, you know, like cool it, you know, chill, do other things. A big thing you'll realize when you get off the apps for a couple of weeks, which I've personally done before, is like you like spend a lot of time on these apps that you don't realize. You could be somebody like me who doesn't even have their notifications on and stuff like that and is never really on their phone. But it doesn't matter. You still, the fact that when you wake up, you probably reach your phone and probably check social media is...
It's an issue
and it's realistic, you know? Once you wake up and you look at your phone and there's nothing to go on, maybe you'll grab a book instead. Maybe you'll go for a walk. I don't know. Anything small, you know?
Yeah.
And you'll just realize, oh, wow, like maybe I am a little dependent on some apps, you know? Without thinking, you know, we put filters on ourselves when we want to take photos, you know? What filter should I put? When was the last time you took a selfie without a filter?
Yeah. And we're not saying, guys, we don't do
this
stuff.
Yeah, like, we do this stuff. Don't get me wrong, but...
But I think being self-aware is, like, really important, you know? Like, knowing, like, you know...
I usually use filters all the time.
Yeah, like, growing up, like, honestly, like, I went through this phase where it's, like, all about, like, social media. Like, normally, like just like any kid in my generation, like... Everyone wanted a phone, like everyone got social media when Instagram Snap first happened. And like, you know, after a while I realized like that's brought so much unnecessary stress and like drama into my
negativity,
life. Like,
yeah.
And I got to a point now where like I can honestly go like the whole day without my phone. Like, you know, people will text me and be like, I'm the worst replier, like, you know this about me. Like, honestly, like if you really need to reach me, like call me. But even then, so like I'm very like not on my phone. And that's important because I realized like honestly, like being dependent on that stuff, like it's not like good. Like, you know, most of the time when I'm on my phone, I'm like either Googling something or like I'm using the GPS or I'm watching a YouTube video on like how to do something. But like, you know, just like realizing like honestly, social media, all this stuff, like TikTok, like all that stuff, like if you feel like your life revolves around it and you can't go without that, then it has some sort of hold over you and that's toxic. Like, that's not it. Like, I know we are in 2020, everyone's on these apps, everyone's entertaining themselves, and that's okay, like, you know, but that is also with boundaries, and that, you know, like, social media and those things are made to literally, like, psychologically, like, brainwash you, like, that's what they're made for, and if you don't realize that, like, you're gonna end yourself in a deep hole, and, you know, a lot of people who are so wrapped around them end up in, like, really bad depressions, you know, because... Honestly, like, they don't really know anything, like, about real socializing. Like, that's not real socializing. Like, I'm sorry, like, talking to people online is not real socializing. Like, there's a big difference. And, you know, obviously, because of COVID, that stuff's been kind of, like, you know, more prominent just because people are so, like, social distancing and stuff. But, like, in real life, it's so sad. Like, people barely have actual face-to-face time, you know, before COVID. Like, I find it's really rare. Like, you know, unless you're really close to the person, you don't really, like, socialize with people like that. You know, even, like, in school, it's kind of like, oh, hi, quick bye-bye. Like, you know, you probably, like, asked a few things. But, like, you don't really have that face-to-face time, which is, like, so important, you know? Like, get out, know people, like, you know, talk to people in your community, like, your neighbors. And when I mean your neighbors, like, not your little neighbors, but, like, you know, people who surround you, like, you know?
Yeah.
It's so important. And just be kind. Honestly, guys, like, just be kind to people. Like, people are so rude nowadays. Like,
and you don't know what people are going through,
you
guys.
Don't
you don't know.
And
like,
it's
you
not
don't know
gonna
what people
hurt.
Are battling. So
it's
not going
to hurt
you
to just be kind to somebody.
Just a smile, literally, guys.
There's,
it's so
like,
cheesy.
Small things,
but...
Like, thank you. Like, how was your day? Like,
yeah.
You know, like, people are going through it, especially right
thank
now.
Thank for the guy behind you at Tim Hortons. Like, literally, he's probably just getting a $2 coffee, guys. Like, literally, small, kind actions will go a long way in some people's lives. You don't know what people are going through. Your smile can... as cheesy as it is, really, like, save someone's life, you know what I'm saying? Like, you might be that light in their life that they needed that one day, and you don't even know it, you know?
Yeah.
But all you said was like, oh, hey, how are you? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Check up on people that you're friends with, you know? Like, shoot a text when you don't hear from someone for a long time. Hey, I miss you, what's up? It's not a bad thing.
Yeah.
It's not beg. It's not a bad thing. It's not, you know, like, we live in a culture, like Nou says, that's really toxic in terms of, like, oh, look, I'm gonna wait for people to come, like, and ask me how I am, like...
No.
Well, then you're going to be waiting for a long time. Like, how about you go out and you ask people how they are? Because maybe they need it, you know?
Yeah.
And just, you know, guys, make sure to be kind as much as you can, because it's what this world lacks,
yeah.
You know? Obviously, going through a pandemic, eye-opener.
Yeah.
But in terms of toxicity, we really think that. Hope this video helped you guys.
Yeah. And honestly, guys, like, just... go get out there, like, stop looking for validation from other people. You don't need it. Like,
don't
the
need
only
it.
Person you need to look for validation
you.
Is you. Like, no one else needs to validate what you're doing. Like, obviously you want to have support from your friends, your family, your parents. Like, those are people, you know, who always want the best for you, hopefully. But, you know, at the end of the day, like, if something doesn't make you happy, if something's not getting you nowhere, and you know that, because we all know when something's not getting us nowhere, we just choose to lie to ourselves. And, you know, that's ignoring red flags and stuff like that. But if you know something's not getting you nowhere, like, you just need to pick yourself up, get on your two feet and walk out. Like, and just, you know, keep doing that. So we really hope this video helps you guys. I know we got a little bit deep. Honestly, we could probably ramble for days about this stuff. But it's just, guys, like, don't be toxic towards yourself. Don't be toxic towards your parents. Don't be toxic towards your friends. Like,
to your relationships. Anything.
Like, if you put out good energy into the world will bring good energy to you. Like, honestly, karma, like, is real. Such a real thing. Like, you know, if you're a good person and you're kind-hearted and you have good intentions, like, God will never leave you. You know, for those of us who do believe, like, God will never leave you. You will never be, like, in need. You will never be left. Like, you know, and sometimes maybe that good karma takes a while to come, but it does come. And you need to always be grateful for that good karma. Because I feel like a human nature, like, we're always so quick to be like, ugh, like, I'm mad, or ugh, this is not working. But, like, when things are good, too, you need to pray. Like, when things are good, too, you need to be grateful. It's not just when things are going bad that you're just, like, it's just going bad. Because, honestly, there's random good. And, you know, just, like, simple things like you having a home, you having friends, you having a family, you having, like, food is, like, good things in your life that you don't realize. Because, honestly, we've seen so many people lose their loved ones. We've seen so many people be crushed by this pandemic, especially. And, like,
check life, your privilege, guys.
Like, life is tough. Yeah, you're very privileged. And just, like, know that and use that privilege to help others, help yourself. Like, you know, and just, you know, rock your world. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we hope you guys like this video.
Helped you guys grow and prosper, and we hope you take this advice with you into 2021.
Hopefully, fingers crossed, it's gonna be a better year. We're all hoping, you know. But make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe, you know,
and send this to somebody who
may need the advice, you know. Guys, we're always willing to help. If you guys ever want to talk, shoot us a DM. Our DMs
are open
for sure, or send us a snap, whatever, you know. We're always here to give advice. We're always here to help people. Honestly, spread life, spread positivity, you know.
Spread love.
You know the vibes. Only good vibes 2021.
Only good vibes on this channel.
For sure.
So see you guys in our next video. Bye.
Like, baby, stop it. Everything's mad if I slap this rocket. Fit like 10 bags in a Mary pocket. I love